Hello and welcome. I have Raghuvendra with me. Congratulations, Raghuvendra. You qualified your UGC NET exam in July 2018 in the subject of management. How are you feeling about this?
Well, thank you. It's once you get done with the exam and you have your certificate in place, you're quite sorted because this exam is valid for a lifetime. So you don't have to worry about its validity or anything of that kind. So you're done with it and you're done with it. So that's how I look at it. So it's a task that we've achieved. And now I'm, currently pursuing my PhD. So the focus is there right now.
That's amazing. And again, congratulations on enrolling in your PhD.
Thank you.
And so tell us more about yourself. Which city were you born in and where did you get your education from?
I come from Hyderabad in the state of Telangana. So I've done most of my education here right up to my bachelor's. So I'm a B.Tech graduate, like most of us from this side of the country are. And then I went out to work with Dell Computers initially. That was my first job. Later, I went on to do my master's and MBA from Symbiosis Pune. So that was the first time about 10 years ago. I moved to Pune, lived there for 2 years. I went to the Media and Communication School there and did an MBA in Communication Management. However, after that, I ended up working for a bank in Bombay. And I worked for the corporate finance division for a bank in Bombay. And I was actually working in the area of finance and it had nothing to do with my background of media, communication and marketing. So then I went on to become an investment banker with a small investment banking firm. And that's when I decided that I always had, I always wanted to move to education. That was always there at the back of my mind. So I took that leap. Coming from the industry and then trying to, moving into education is definitely, especially in India, it's a very big decision that you have to make. So you need a lot of things to fall in place for you to get there. And I thought, okay, let me get there. Let me get a job. So I work for my alma mater in Hyderabad now. I work with Symbiosis Hyderabad campus right now. And I'm in an administrative role here. And simultaneously, I'm also pursuing my PhD. The first thing I had in mind was if I was continuing with my regular job, I was not sure if I'm going to be serious about giving the NET exam and clearing it. So only when I thought that, okay, let me change my job, let me get into education, then I won't have an option but to, clear the exam first and also complete my PhD. So my first attempt in July 2018, I cleared the NET and thanks to Human Peritus because it actually helped me focus on the right things because there is so much, there's so much to learn. When you look at the portion that is given out, there is a lot, but Human Peritus actually helped me out. So we can, actually talk about it through this.
Very interesting. A lot of points I want to talk about here. First of all, so you came back to giving the exam after a lot of years after your post graduation.
Yes.
So how challenging was that part?
See, it works differently for many people. I have been a guy who's always been, I have had this examination phobia all through my life. So if you look at my academic record, in terms of marks, it's not really great. So that's always been at the back of my mind. And once you get into the industry, it's very difficult for you to go back and give an exam. And especially when you want to give a competitive exam, the challenges are, you kind of make it difficult for you in your mind. So it is, to begin with, it was difficult. But once you get into the groove, I think it's very easy. So I would only say that if I could clear the exam, anybody can. Given my past academic record, anybody can clear the exam.
I think you're taking a lot of credit from yourself here. And you were in a job while you were preparing. So how did you tackle the time management part?
See, time, yes, I had to burn some midnight oil, no doubt about it, because work has always been hectic and it eats up your weekdays and you have very little time. But if you can have a focused 2 to 3 hours on a daily basis where you're completely focused on preparing for the exam and you do it for about 3 to 4 months, I think it's more than enough for you to clear the exam. It's more than enough. Or maybe a couple of months if you're really quick at picking up things, I think that should be more than sufficient for you to clear this exam.
All right. Now I want to talk to you about the subjects. So being from an engineering background, I don't believe paper 1 was a challenge for you. And how challenging was paper 2?
Well, paper 2 was definitely challenging. When it comes to paper 1, I think everybody has to focus more on paper 1 when you're giving the exam. People often tend to focus on paper 2 because they feel that this is my subject area and I can score more. But that's where I believe I've known some other people who were, you know, giving this exam, and that's where they fumbled. So though they knew the subject better than I did who cleared the exam, they could not clear the exam because they were focusing too much. They were putting in too much of their energy into paper 2. Of course, paper 2 is important, but paper 1 is scoring. Because many people miss out the small things in paper 1 where you can score full marks. Of course, paper 1 in terms of time, it could be time consuming compared to paper 2. So in paper 1, you have to focus on, say there are a few questions related to math, there are a few questions related to logical reasoning. I think there's also a little bit of reading comprehension. So you focus on the 30% of paper 1 and make sure that you score 100% there. That will actually get you across the cutoff. So that is something which is very important, and people often miss that. Their energy goes into paper 2 and they don't practice paper 1 pretty well. And it's much easier as far as paper 1 is concerned if I have to compare it with, say, the people who are giving their subject as management. For them, they have to focus more on paper 1 because at some point in time in their career, they would have tried to, you know, give the CAT exam. And so if I say the CAT has 3 levels, and when you actually take CAT coaching, if I go back 10-12 years, when we used to go to certain coaching institutes to take CAT coaching, they would say level 1, level 2 and level 3, and level 3 is where CAT is. So here I think level 1 is more than enough, and people often overlook this and they end up missing those marks which could be easily scored. So that's where the difference is according to me. And when it comes to paper 2, there are challenges because people would have specialized in a particular subject. It could be marketing, it could be finance. So for me, marketing was known to me because I studied that back in college. Finance is also known to me because I've been in practice. But when it came to operations and human resources, it was kind of alien. So first of all, try to build on what you already know so that you get your answers right. And then try to understand certain areas conceptually right. So getting those concepts right are very important rather than mugging up a lot of things and trying to know those answers. It doesn't work that way. So you get your concepts right and you can answer many questions because you can take the risk in this exam. I think there is no negative marking even now, right? So your risks are pretty low. So you can, if you know the concept right, there's a fair chance of you getting those answers right by doing some guesswork also at some point.
I think I agree with the things you've said here, especially the paper 1 thing. It gets you more results with less time that you can put into it, and those marks should not be lost at all because paper 2 is very unpredictable. Paper 1 is more predictable in that sense as well. And so now, after qualifying the NET exam, how do you see yourself? Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Well, it's a different ballgame after you qualify the NET exam. The first priority I have right now is to, you know, complete my PhD at the earliest. So maybe 2 years from now, I should be able to, you know, complete my PhD. And 5 years from now, I would only be talking about my areas of research. even now I can do that, but I will be able to, you know, talk about it with more confidence. So that's it. So it's teaching and research after this. Because you're done with NET, you really don't have to think about it.
I'm glad that giving this exam has opened up so many opportunities for you. And not only PhD, I'm sure you'll go on to do great things. And thank you for taking out time and speaking with us. And we wish you all the best for all your future endeavors.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.